Welcome back, trainers, and in this video we're going to be going over Swablu Community Day information as well as Mega Altaria raid counters and Yveltal raid counters when we do get towards the end here. So do give this video a thumbs up if you do enjoy these information videos. So Swablu Community Day, very interesting. I know it was pretty hard on it when it first was announced. Moonblast, I was just saying, yeah, no, it's not that great. It's okay. Okay, you know, it is a direct upgrade from what it has, Dazzling Gleam. Okay, so it is going to be better than what it currently is. Dragon Claw would have been a little OP. Take a look at this very nice image by Legends here, and we'll look at some other information here in just a moment. But you're going to be able to get that distance cut down, and you can see the various different distances for all of the eggs in the regular incubators and in the super incubators as well. And take a look at the IVs that you're going to want for the Great League as well as the Ultra. You're going to want the best IVs for Ultra because that's where it is going to be completely maxed out at. So, very nice stuff. Let's go ahead and move on to the raids for Mega Altaria. Straight up Metagross, folks. Okay, so if you have a shadow powered up beyond 40, you're going to be looking good. If you have a shadow powered up to 40, you're still going to be looking good. And then the regular Metagross, of course, you're going to have Meteor Mash, so also keep that in mind. And then you're going to be getting that Community Day box. I know I didn't talk about it, but you know it's going without having to say because we get it every single Community Day, as well as 5 snapshots in where Swablu will appear. So Mega Altaria, a very interesting Pokemon. It is going to be Dragon and Fairy, so it's not weak to Fairy. Very interesting. So that's where we bust out the Steel and bust out the Poison, and also the Fairy types. So this is going to be pretty awesome because when you do get it, say you get enough of those Mega Energies to use it, you're going to be able to boost Fairy type attacks, which is going to be pretty nice to get that extra damage if you do have those, I don't know, Gardevoirs. As you can see on the first page, Shadow Gardevoir is going to be coming in number 6. And we're just going to go down the list from best to worst. We're not going to separate them or categorize them by weather. We're just going to brush over it because we don't need to get too in-depth about that. And then you do have Mega Gengar, which is going to be helping you get a boost on the poison typing, which it's also going to be weak to because it's fairy. So you have a lot of different combinations going on here to take this thing out, and where you can just go with those shadow Metagross, regular Metagross, Meteor Mash it to death, or you can bring in those Megas to get the boost on the poison typings, and then eventually Mega Altaria to help you get the boost on the fairy typings, just going crazy with the damage. Moving down the list here, we do have Shadow Mewtwo, and by the way, these images on the left are going to be from PokeBattler, which I will also have a link to. Very good source for information on Pokemon Go, of course. So number 7, Mewtwo with Psycho Cut and Ice Beam, Shadow, of course, Mega Abomasnow, Powder Snow, and Weather Ball, Dialga, Metal Claw, and Iron Head. So these are going to be level 40s, right? And then regular Mamoswine with the moves that you already know what it needs, Shadow Scizor, and then Galarian Germanitan. Galarian Germanitan is very squishy, but it does have a pretty decent time there. Moving on down the list, the reason why there's 2 Genesects is because we do have the regular one and the Burn Drive, and there's no difference between them. They're just, you know, both labeled there because there are 2 separate Pokemon in the game. And then you have Excadrill, Shadow Aggron, funny enough, because, well, Steel-type moves are super effective to vary. Mega Victory Bell, which would be absolutely insane. With Acid, really horrible move, and then Sludge Bomb, but it's Shadow, so it's just doing a ton, plus Stab. And then Roserade with Sludge Bomb and Poison Jab. That's going to be another fantastic pick. A really good time to win there if you do have those powered up. I personally do have a bunch. And then you have Shadow Ursa Ring with Metal Claw and Play Rough. Both of those are super effective. The Shadow Vileplume. All right, very interesting if you have one of those powered up. Cool, Acid and Sludge Bomb. Shadow Muk, Poison Jab, and Gunk Shot. Jirachi, of course, regular. There's no Shadow Mythicals with Confusion and Doom Desire. Doom Desire being that stab and super effective. Regular Mewtwo with Psycho Cut and Ice Beam. And this is exactly what I was talking about in my other video. You had that Shadow Mewtwo at the top, and that's why I don't want to put 2 legacy moves on it, so I can have a little diversity between different raids as I so choose to change that move. And if I have 2 legacies, well, there's no changing it. And then Gardevoir at 24. Taking a look at the top fairy type attackers, not to belittle the Mega Altaria or anything. It is, you know, it's a decent Pokemon. It's a very interesting one, but it is definitely not going to be on the first page. It's just the competition is very steep. Not so much for the fairies, because there's really not too many shadows there. But when it comes to dragons, the competition is just off the charts. We already know this. You have the Mega Rayquaza, which is not here. Mega Garchomp, which is not here. Shadow Salamence, technically the best dragon type attacker, but it's horrible on the survivability. But nonetheless, yeah, there you go as comparison. So taking a look at Yveltal, we'll be here on May 18th until May 31st. Folks, you know what? You're definitely gonna want to raid this one. And the reason why I didn't go hard on the current one that we do have, the fairy, I'm not a fan of that thing. If I had good moves, I'd go pretty hard on it, but it doesn't have good moves. So I kind of just did a few. Sorry if I'm ignoring your invites, if you're sending them on my friends list, but I have to save those passes for the Yveltal here because this thing is gonna be disgusting. As you can see, Shadow Raikou, Shadow Zapdos, Zekrom, Mega Manectric, Shadow Electivire, Thunderous Theronform. So you're going to have all these electric types. So you maybe want to use Mega Ampharos or Mega Manectric to get the boost on those electric types just to do that much more damage. Moving down the list, you have Shadow Magnezone, which is also going to be just dishing out the damage there. Shadow Mamoswine, Shadow Gardevoir, which, yeah, let's get it with that. And you're going to be able to use Mega Altaria to get the boost with the Fairy typing to help you take this thing out even better with your fairy types or with the Mega Altaria. Have a little fun there. It's not going to be the best choice, and it's, you know, but it's something new, something interesting to boost those fairies. Rhyperior, Shadow Tyranitar, and then regular Raikou at 12 there. Moving down the list at 13, Rampardos. Very interesting to see this thing farther down the list. It's usually at the top. It does have a great time to win, surpassing pretty much everything else, but it's going to take nearly 40, okay? Yeah, nearly 40. Then you have Shadow Weavile, another very squishy Pokemon, taking even more, but also with a lesser time. Regular Electivire, Shadow Aerodactyl, regular Zapdos, and then Mega Abomasnow. So remember, those Megas are going to help you out quite a bit to get those boosts. So yeah, Mega Ampharos there, and then Terrakion at 20, and then Mega Ampharos at 19. So, you know, it's down the list there, but you also are going to be giving the boost to those stronger shadows, potentially. Shadow Mewtwo with Psycho Cut and Ice Beam. There you go, another example. But it's at 21. It's not like, oh, I need to use my Mewtwo. Magnezone regular with its typical moves. Luxray, it's nice to see that on the list, but still farther down. Regular Mamoswine, of course, with the standard moves there. So this is going to be a very interesting raid, folks. Are you going to do a bunch? I'm going to do a bunch. Oh yeah, I'm going to try to get enough to make an XL. Period. Simple as that. A couple? Nah, just one's good. Not trying to invest that much, right? So we have Galarian Dramanitan at 25, regular Gardevoir, Shadow Arcanine, regular Togekiss, as if there's a shadow. Yikes, that sounds scary. And then you have the Alolan Golem and Shadow Magneton. Very interesting. Thank you for watching. If you did enjoy this, give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you're new, turn notifications on. Good luck out there catching swine nubs, and take care, trainers.